Hello everyone, welcome back. This will be the makeup that I used up in 2017. I am very excited to show you what I've used up in the last year. I have things from every category, which is really nice. And I will show you individually the products I used up, and in the video clip, it will inform you of the... Alright, so I will show you the items I used up and if any of them were my favorites. Alright, so let's get into it.
These are the 5 full-size mascaras, the Ulta Plus Drama, Tarte Lights Camera Lashes, Clean Color Framus Lash, M. Michelle, their Lash Gallery, and Maybelline Great Lash. I would buy the Tarte again, and I like the M. Michelle one. These are the 3 mini deluxe sample mascaras I used up. Makeup Forever Excessive Lash, The Balm Mad Lash, and Benefits They're Real. I would purchase They're Real again. 2 lip liners, one from Tarte, their Tartiest Lip in Later Gram, and a dual ended lip liner from Ulta in the shade Flesh and My Berry. I would purchase the My Berry end of the Ulta one. 5 lipsticks, one from Jane, the NARS Velvet Lip Glide, Hello Sailor from Lipstick Queen, Violet Shine from NYC, and Shameless from Be a Bombshell. I would purchase all of them again in the future, except for the Jane. They no longer sell that one. But Bound was my favorite. I had 1 blush from e.l.f. This was their HD cream blush in Headliner. I would not purchase it again. I had 4 liquid foundations. From Supergoop, their CC Cream in Light Medium, Dr. Jart BB Balm, the IT Cosmetics CC Plus Your Skin But Better in Medium, and Smashbox Camera Ready BB Cream in Light Medium. I like the IT Cosmetics and the Smashbox. Then I had 2 powder foundations, 1 loose, 1 pressed. I would not purchase either. One was from Bare Minerals, their original SPF 15 foundation in medium beige, and Bonnibel's No Shine Pressed Powder. The Bonnibel they no longer make, but it was my shade. The Bare Minerals was not. I had 4 brow products. From Flirt, their Clear Deal 3-in-1 Lash Glosser Primer Brow Groomer. I used it in my brows. The Ulta Brow Gel, it was clear. IT Cosmetics Brow Power in Universal Taupe, it was a Universal Eye Pencil. And Benefits Gimme Brow. I like the 2 clear brow gels and the Gimme Brow Brow Tint. I didn't care for the pencil, it was too hard. 1 concealer for under the eye from IT Cosmetics, the Bye Bye Under Eye Illumination. I didn't like this one. It was too shiny. It had sparkle in it. 1 loose setting powder from City Color. This was their HD powder. I did like this. 2 makeup sponges. The pink one was from Ulta. It was very dry in material. I don't know if they've reformulated it. And the blue one is from Ricky's NYC. It's their classic 3D blender. I really like that one. That one's really soft. It expanded nicely. My makeup looked great. 1 eyeshadow quad. This was from Be a Bombshell. This is their Bora Bora quad. I really enjoyed this quad. It has really great shades in it, but they started to dry out and they were no longer workable. But I did hit pan in all of it. 3 eyeshadow primers. The small one is from Bare Minerals. It's their 5-in-1 cream eyeshadow base. The e.l.f. mineral eyeshadow base. And the Hard Candy eyeshadow primer. I would purchase the Bare Minerals 5-in-1 again in a different shade. 3 lip tints or stains from Tony Moly. Their Tony Tint Delight in number 2 red. The Balms Stainiac and Pop Beauty Stay Pout liner in Fuchsia Freesia. I would not purchase any of them. 1 lip scrub from Hannah Lay. This is their sugar lip scrub. I would repurchase. This is 1 eyeliner pencil from Lord & Barry. I would repurchase this. 4 lip glosses. 1 from Bath & Body Works and Forever Red. An Ulta Super Shiny Lip Gloss and Poppy. The Too Faced Lip Injection Extreme. And another Ulta Super Shiny in Flirtini. I liked the formula of the Ulta Super Shinies, but they're under different colors now, and they've changed some of the glitter bases in them. But I like both the Bath & Body Works and the Ulta Poppy, the red ones in color. 4 primers. The Smashbox Photo Finish Color Correcting Adjust. It was a green one. The Manicadar Sheer Glow Shimmer Lotion from Glam Glow. The Glow Starter Mega Illuminating Moisturizer from Dr. Brandt, the Pores No More. The only one I loved was the Dr. Brandt Pores No More. 4 liquid eyeliners from Nika K. Their Shimmer Eyeliner in green. Seraphine Botanicals, or Seraphina. The Liquid Kohl from Essence. Their Super Fine Waterproof. And Kat Von D's Tattoo Liner in Trooper. I like the Nika K because I like the applicator. And I really love the Kat Von D Tattoo Liner. I have 17 lip balms, and I would buy the Pixie Tinted Brilliance Balm, Lip Smacker, this Betty Crocker Brownie Fudge. The Alba one was very soft. I liked anything from Avon. Chapstick was nice. Carmex. That's it. I have 4 setting sprays. Urban Decay All Nighter, NYX Matte Finish, Shiseido Ibuki, and the Basha White Charcoal. I would only purchase the Urban Decay All Nighter and the NYX Matte. I finished 5 nail polishes. The small one is from Sally Beauty. It's in their Sally Girl line. A Sally Hansen Diamond Strength Perfect Formula Pink Gel Coat, a Sally Hansen Clear Coat, and from Formula X, their Bond, Ionic Bond. I enjoyed using all of them. The clear one is a clear. The pink gel coat is like pink armor. I like the Sally Hansen, but I have tons more. The Sally Girl was nice as a topper, and this Bond, Ionic Bond from Formula X is the one I would repurchase again, but they no longer make that. I have 3 bronzers. 1 from Pixie Beauty in Subtly Suntouched. Siete London Bamboo Bronzer in Palm Island. And Elizabeth Mott What Up Beaches. I like the Siete London and I like the Pixie. I have 2 Ulta Beauty Oil Free eye makeup removers. They were 15 pads in each one. I have a Maybelline Clean Express makeup remover for the eye and a Garnier Skin Active Micellar Cleansing Water, the all-in-one that removed waterproof makeup. I like the Ulta eye removing pads and the Maybelline Clean Express, but they don't make that anymore. And the micellar water, found out that it's drying out my eyelids, so I'm glad to be done with that one. I have 9 makeup removing wipes. Sephora Rose Cleansing Wipes. They were fine. The Neutrogena Makeup Remover Cleansing Towelettes and Night Calm. They were okay. I have 2 of the Simple Cleansing Facial Wipes, and I really do like those. Forever Young by Jean Pierre, their makeup removing and cleansing wipes. I like these. I like the Wet n Wild Under the Sheets makeup remover wipes. And I have 3 of the wipes from AOA Studio. 1 in citrus. 1 in green tea. And 1 in rose water. They were on par with the Wet n Wild. These are my 58 fragrance samples. The ones I would buy full size are the Ralph Love by Ralph Lauren. Givenchy, I can't even say it right now. The Dahlia Divine Le Nectar de Parfum. I like the Versace Bright Crystal. I like the Citrus Scents from Atelier. The Mon Grulin was good. Coach Poppy Prada Candy. I love Juicy Couture. The Harvey Prince ones I tried. I had 1 rollerball in the scent Forever Red from Bath & Body Works. Then I had 9 perfumes. Katy Perry's Mad Potion. Estee Lauder Modern Muse La Roche. This is Very Sexy from Victoria's Secret. Shades from Bath & Body Works, their Coconut Lime Verbena, a Calgon Hawaiian Ginger, Bath & Body Works, Coconut Vanilla from their Signature Vanillas line, and 2 of the Bath & Body Works Japanese Cherry Blossom Body Splashes. I love the Japanese Cherry Blossom. The Coconut Vanilla was good. Hawaiian Ginger was good. Coconut Lime Verbena. Modern Muse La Roche. I own a big one. Very Sexy, Shades, weren't what I remember them to be. And the Katy Perry was too sweet. And it didn't last.
Alright you guys, so that was my makeup that I used up in 2017. I used up 155 products, individual ones, for a total of $616.01. So that's a really nice amount to have used up. This is my first year containing all of my makeup empties to show. It would be nice to hit an even 1,000 for this year. So I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, please hit that thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed, please do. I would love to have you. And if you've already subscribed, thank you very much. I want you guys to be safe, be well. Peace.